Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 4.2, Problem 1. This is Section 4.2, Problem Number 1. It says, a teacher from Math 119 class at BCC spends years studying the relationship between the number of hours students spend studying each week and the grade that they get for the course. After tracking 500 students over an 8-year period, this teacher feels that the regression equation is y equals 42.1 plus 9.3x. That's your y equals a plus bx equation. Part A, do you feel that the number of hours spent studying is the explanatory variable or the response variable? So in other words, the number of hours you spend studying, are you putting that in for the x? Or is that the answer you're getting out for the y? Well, it is going to be the value you put in for the x. What you get for the y, the response, the grade for the course. So explanatory is the number of hours that you spend studying. Response is the grade for the course. B, predict the grade for the course that a student that spends 6 hours every week doing the homework. So if you spend 6 hours a week on the homework, what can you expect for the grade based on this teacher's previous work? So if my equation is y equals 42.1 plus 9.3 times x, for part B, the value of x is 6. That's the number of hours that you spend studying. So put that in for x, 42.1 plus 9.3 times 6. Now again, remember, if you have an addition and a multiplication, you must do the multiplication first. That's simply the order of operations. You can't, even though going from left to right, they add is written first, you must multiply first. So y would equal 42.1 plus 9.3 times 6 is 55.8. And now if you add 42.1 plus 55.8, the answer for that comes out to 97.9. So that student would get a good strong A. Rounding that off, that's a 98 average for the class. So 6 hours a week would get you a good grade for this class. Now part C is predict the grade for the course for a student that spends 3 hours every week doing the homework. So same process, except you put in a 3 for x. So where I had started with the equation before, 42.1 plus 9.3 times x, the value of x is now going to be 3. So 42.1 plus 9.3 times x becomes 9.3 times 3. Again, you have an addition and a multiply. You must do the multiply first. That's the rule for statistics, for trig, for geometry, for every type of math. You must multiply first. So y equals 42.1 plus 9.3 times 3 is 27.9. And then if you add 42.1 plus 27.9, it comes out to a nice whole number of 70. So if a student is spending 3 hours a week on the homework, they can get a 70 or a low C. That'd probably be a C minus. Now, D says, if 3,78 is an actual data point from the scatter diagram, what is the residual? So this scatter diagram would have 500 points on it because the teacher tracked 500 students. One of those 500 points is over 3 up 78. That's the point on the diagram. So the residual, what they're asking you is, what's the difference between the predicted value and the actual value of one of the data points? So the predicted value, if you put in a 3 for your x, we see is 70. So the residual for this point is the difference between the 70 that you predicted and the 78 that a real student actually got. So the residual, 78, the real data point, minus 70, the predicted data point, gives you a residual of 8.